Hey everyone, this is LiKimmiDee and we are back again with my 2018 Street Triple 765. Today we will be installing the tail tidy. My husband told me that that's what it's supposed to be called, but I call it a Fender Eliminator.
I call it a Fender Eliminator.
Yeah, so that's what we are working on today, and let's do it. So this is what we are getting rid of. It is nasty, it is ugly, it's like, it's just ugly.
We got 1, 2, 3 that's gonna have to come out, and that'll get rid of our big hunk of junk here. I gotta get these plastics out, so I'm probably gonna have to take the seat out so I can get to the bolts that are holding our tail light in. And here's our connectors, so we can go ahead and unplug those now for the plate mount. So they're tucked inside of that bar there. So there's that. So far, most of the smaller bolts on the Street Triple seem to be 5/16. Hold it for me.
I am holding that.
All right, go ahead. Should come off now.
Push it.
I'm getting there.
Push it.
That's what she said.
Push it.
There we go.
All right, you guys, here is this ugly hunk of junk. I am gonna put it on the towel over here, and we are gonna see how ugly you guys can reminisce in the ugliness of this big bulky piece of crap. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that. We are installing an integrated tail light.
Motodynamic is the company for this particular one. Had them several times in the past and no issues whatsoever. Unfortunately for my CDR, not unfortunately, I definitely like the one I got, but Motodynamic did not make an integrated that went into the actual tail, because the CBR's tail light is mounted to that big ugly fender. So I have the TST on the CBR. And as I said, not unfortunately, I absolutely love the product. No issues with it. But all of Kim's bikes I've put Motodynamic on. So.
We. Us.
We.
I gotta be so judging about my seat.
So now that I got the seat out of the way, it's gonna be 1, 2, and 3 for each side plastic here. Now I'm gonna leave one in, and we're just gonna push them over and off to the side until I determine whether or not I want to tuck any wires, and then I'll move one of these out of the way. So we got 4 of those out, 2 and 4. We moved it over, spread them cheeks. Let's get the taillight off. So it looks like you pull this little plastic screw out. It's just one of the little pop clips, it looks like.
Triumph. Okay. Anyways.
And you're able to lift up this little piece of plastic here to get to our wire for the tail light. There we go.
Stop what you're doing.
Oh, it's down there.
Give it.
I'll have to get it later. Plastic, please.
Plastic?
Grab the plastics.
Oh.
Thank you.
Oh, her rear end is so naked, you guys. Look at how naked she is. She's being more naked than ever. Oh, her battery's showing. Stop it.
Very nice. How much?
Okay, so what we had to do is we disconnected. Let me get on this other side. We disconnected the tail light. We pulled the tail light out. Before we had to do that, we had to show them this black piece that I'm holding.
So I had to pull out the undertail because the tail light's actually tucked into it. Yep. So it's just two bolts that hold that guy in. Boom, boom. The rest is held in when you actually bolt the light back together. It actually is part of this tail or undertail. So we're gonna set our undertail off the side. And here is our new tail light. It's plug and play aside from the indicators that need to be wired in, which those will come off of our big doohickey that the friggin' fender was mounted to. My brain quit working for a second there. Get it up in there. Boom. Grab our undertail again. Two bolts.
Now that looks real good.
This harness was inside of the rear fender that we already took off. So we had to disassemble, as you can see right there, the fender to get this harness out.
So you would have to do the two screws right there, and then the third one.
Yep, you have to undo three cap screws in order to get to it, guys. Yep, zip tie it nice and tight right there. All right. So this goes to our license plate light. Then these go to our turn signals, which I need my adapter at this point. So lots and lots of light wires that in the end are all gonna be tucked and hidden, if at all possible. As you guys can see in the camera, my son is flossing for some reason. Next to the bike. Have to push and make sure you get these things all the way on. There we go. Put your waterproofing little things in there. So the colors obviously match up, blue to blue, black to black on the same harness, and then the other side. Oh, take that back. We got green here. Look at the color matching on there for me. Blue is left, yellow is right. Oh, lovely. The, you know,
always
they're labeled. Yep, so it looks like this will be a plug and play test. Okay, so we're checking. Let's see. Go right, please. Oh, look, I hooked it up right. Go left. Oh, look, I hooked it up right. Turn the key off now, please. All right, guys, so we're gonna play tuck, tuck, tuck. Okay. Pliers here, we're gonna do some wire tucking. Hey, where you at with them zip ties? We need to figure out how and where we're gonna tuck all this. So, let's go ahead and make our little zip tie here. Tie that one. That one to that one. Zip tie.
But I just did this.
Nope, you did one. I'm gonna stop right there. Of course, she's gotta get me zip tied. But I wanna figure out where this guy is gonna get tucked at. It looks like I'm gonna be taking up some of the storage space under here and tucking it down that way. So. I love Motodynamic products, like I said earlier, but man, there's a lot of wires. Let's make sure that our guy right here is out of the way. Let's see. Hmm.
Give me those. Why'd you pick those up? I need those. Right back where I had.
I feel like you're wasting zip ties.
I am. Stop picking them up.
What? At this point, you're just picking them up on purpose.
No, you're putting parts on my bike or tools on my bike without, you know. Now you just put wrenches on top of your bike.
I will, thank you. Plastics, because we are ready to put those back on at this point. Also helps when you put them on the right sides. We had 6 bolts for that. Cap screw bolts, whatever you guys want to call it. I actually need your second set of hands for the moment.
Darn it.
Yeah. We use our big washers here, Kim. Here. Do that one. I just bumped my camera there. All right, here you go. All right, I'm gonna let go of this now so I can grab the other ones. Can't spin them, Kim. So, I'll move my camera. I'm working out under here. So, you got your bolts going through. Oh, where's that third one? Right in the middle, I believe. Yep. Oh, fuck that one. I don't have the fingers for that. Here, stick that.
Oh my gosh, I will do it.
Yeah, and I'm gonna tighten the screw. When you get the, just get the nut around the wire. It's up there. Just get the nut around it and I will twist the screw. Tell me when you're ready. Am I even twisting the right one? Is it twisting?
I don't know, but mine's in.
Oh, well, I also have the wrong size Allen head. How did I get that out in the first place? Got it on there? Is that it?
Yeah.
All right. Now, where's that other tool I have? Oh, there it is. Put that guy on tighten.
This is the wrong size.
Oh, that's why I have the wrong size. Because it switched on me. I forgot we switched, guys. So the ones that you're putting on are not the same as the size that came off. Thank you. There you go. That ought to do the trick.
Can I have the ratchet? Or are you just gonna...
Alright, which one are we starting on?
Bottom.
There we go. We got that guy in place.
So now we have...
Now Kim needs to figure out where she wants her...
Relay? What is that?
Oh, never mind. This one is nice. See, mine actually came with double-sided sticky tape. Oh, somebody's going by. Whereas yours, Kim, is bolted on there.
Aw, snap.
We will go ahead and put on our plate light. It goes up here. You gotta feed your wires through one at a time, it looks like. Fun. All right. It's a pretty nice looking plate light there. Kinda like that. Hey, little hands, you want to do this part? No? Okay.
That's funny watching you struggle, but sure, I'll do it.
That washer just fall off again. Yeah. Here.
Give me the screw.
Just put the dang washer on there.
Oh my gosh. Where's the screw?
It's in the socket here.
Oh, you cheater.
Yeah, flanged bolts are the best. At this point, I will no longer be able to ride her bike. Because I am willing to bet I will be scraping plate. So. Let's finish up. Kimmy took the plate off her old fender. Taking the time to mount it on the new one. On this one, it's already set the way we want it. But all the Motodynamic taillights have a button on the back. Just like this. And you can change it. It'll come with the instructions, and you don't really need the instructions. You just tap the button and hit the brakes and see how it changed. So that's that. We got the Fender Eliminator on with the plate light and the integrated tail light. So we'll go ahead and finish piecing it back together, and LiKimmiDee will do a nice walk around of her bike for the end of the video. So let's wrap that up. Out with the walk around.
You guys, it has been a very long day. This whole Fender Eliminator plus the tail light took a little more longer than anticipated, but we will put all the links to these products in our description, and if you are interested in buying them, you can go to the link to purchase them. We are no way, shape, or form sponsoring these. I wish.
Sponsored by. I'm definitely sponsoring the products. Yeah. They're awesome products.
But that's about it. So yeah, so we're signing out. This is LiKimmiDee.
And this is Ketch with Third Gear. If you like the video, click the like button below. Leave comments in the comments section. We'll reply to them as we need to. Thanks, guys.
Bye.